This morning our subject is Gems from the Garden of Saints, part 12. We are studying Swami Vishuddhananda Ji's Sat Prasanga. This Swami was a disciple of Holy Mother and later became the president of the Ramakrishna Order. A great illumined soul. He used to give talk to the devotees in the afternoon, which are recorded. They are very, very inspiring and practical in spiritual life. Before I begin the subject, I shall give you a little introduction. It was 17th October 1882. Narendra, at that time a young college student, came to Sri Ramakrishna with some of his Brahmo Devuk friends. Seeing these young boys, Sri Ramakrishna told them, "Dive deep. You boys are trying to practice spiritual discipline in a very superficial way. Learn how to dive deep." In that connection, he sang a song of Ram Prasad. "Dub de re mon kali bole, ridhi ratna kare agad chale." Oh my mind, dive deep in the inner recess of your heart, chanting Divine Mother's name. A few times you always remember, all gems and jewels are at the bed of that ocean. If you do not get the gems and jewels after giving a few dives, don't think there is no gems there. Very beautiful words. Ratnakarna shunya kakhon duchar dube dhanna mole tumi dam samorthe ag dube jao kulokunjolinir kule. But do you know, let me tell you the secret. You take a deep breath and go in the bottom of kulokunjolini, the bottom of your backbone, where is the kunjolini, the place of kunjolini. And then there are 6 inches of kundalini, as you know, and this Kram Chakra is the 6th one. Dive deep there. Then you will definitely get the gems and jewels. Then he cautioned them. Those words are also very beautiful. Kamadi chai kumbhi rachesh sadai lobesh, but Kamadi chai kumbhirache, shadai chale, tumi bibi khul di gai meke jao chobenatar gandha pele. But I caution you, when you dive deep, there are 6 alligators who will attack you. They are around that place, protecting those gems and jewels. Those 6 alligators are lust, anger, greed, delusion, ego, and jealousy. Your 6 enemies are always around that place. But let me tell you the technique. If you besmear your body with turmeric of dispassion, discrimination, those crocodiles will not come near you. Raton manik kato pori ache sei jale ram prasad bole jhompo dile milbe raton phale phale. Beautiful. The Ram Prasad, the great mystic, tells you that if you really dive deep, if you really give jump and go below, definitely you will get gems and jewels. Singing a song, Ramakrishna was not very, did not stop there. Do you know what did he do? He gave some instructions how to meditate. After giving some instructions, he told them, now you go to Panchavati and meditate there. They are all young college kids. They went and started to meditate in the Panchavati. After a short while, Sri Ramakrishna went to check. I'm telling you, the sign of a good teacher. He went to check that whether they're really meditating or chatting. He saw they're all meditating. Sri Ramakrishna was very pleased to say that, tell them, see them. And then they came down from that big pedestal around the Panchavati, and he was telling a story. You know, meditation is very good. But let me tell you the problem. Why do you not get good meditation? He did not quote the scripture. He only told the folklore. In a village, there is a young boy named Padmalochan, a crazy boy. He used to play his flute and blow the conch. There was a dilapidated Shiva temple in the village. And in that temple, there are many bats, rats, bad odor. The temple was really in bad shape, uncleaned. There are some trees grow around on the top of the temple. I mean, completely bad. In that temple, one evening, this Podo, he started to blow his conch. And the villagers thought someone must be installed the deity, God. So they all rushed to see. The moment they came, they found Podo is dancing and blowing his conch inside. And a lot of bats are jumping and flying. They're very uncomfortable. Sri Ramakrishna made there's a song there. Podo shakfule tui korli gol ta chamchika agar jona divanishe dicche hana. There are 11 bats are there in that temple. The 11 bats are our 11 sense organs. 5 organs of knowledge, 5 organs of action and the mind. These 11 bats are flying. So Sri Ramakrishna told them, look, if you really want good meditation, you must learn how to control these 11 senses. Then you will get deep meditation. Then only you can dive deep. Otherwise, you boys read a few books, memorize a few verses, and want to give lecture. It will not work. I was just reading Friday night in Kansas City, this part of the gospel, and I was thinking, Sri Ramakrishna's method of teaching. How beautiful. You can visualize one after another how he is teaching these young kids. That is my introduction. Shat Prasanga. Ramakrishna Mission, Silchar, 13th April, 1957. Swami Vishuddhananda quoted a line of a mystic song. Go anandamai hoye amar, mamai niranandha korona. Mother, I know you are the blissful one, but don't make my life miserable. I am your son, and you are the blissful mother. How should I be miserable? Quoting that line, Swami continued. This song is sung from Pique, P-I-Q-U-E. This devotee is trying utmost to realize God, praying to God, meditating on God, repeating mantra on God. But he is not getting any response. So he is very upset. This is, most of us feel the same way. Mother, I am calling you so much, still there is no end of misery. If you do not rescue me, who else? This is the domain of Jwarbhata in spiritual life. Ebb tide and low tide, ebb tide and low tide. Sometimes mind is little up, again it is down. So mind is fluctuating. That is, many of us face this problem every day. Sometimes plateau, mind is not working. The Christian mystics call it dark night of the soul. Very painful. Mind is not working. I am not getting that intensity, longing, hunger for God. Mind is depressed, down. The Swami is encouraging the devotees. Do you see the Ganges? In Calcutta, to Ganges, it is 40 to 60 miles from Bay of Bengal. So every 6 hours, the current changes. High tide, low tide. High tide, low tide. 4 times a day, the current of the river changes. So he said, same thing in spiritual life. Sometimes high tide, mind goes up, sometimes down. But did you see? In Haridwar, in Banaras, there is only one current, nearly 500 but 1,000 miles away from the Bay of Bengal, the meeting point of the Ganges and the ocean. There, one current. A period comes in spiritual life when you will get continuous flow, continuous thought of God. But before that, you will have to practice hard. At that time, you will get uninterrupted peace and bliss. Then he said, even Sri Ramakrishna had to pass through this problem. He said, Mother, you gave vision to Ramprasad, Ramkanta, Kamalakanta, and we do not reveal yourself to me. Mother, I am calling you so much, still you are not responding. I remember one story. Holy Mother had she was very sick in Jayarambati, and she was praying to the Mother. 3 days, no response. Even she was depressed. Then on the 4th day, when the disciple came, do you know what did she say? You know, I'll be cured very soon. Why? Last night, Mother Jagadhatri came. Even Holy Mother had to fight for 3 days. Who is the incarnation of the Divine Mother in human form? And who are you and who am I? Never be discouraged in spiritual life. As Swamiji says, never give up hope. You will see the light. When you attain samadhi, no problem. Bas, that is one current. Next, he says the word you will have to understand, Obhiman. Obhiman means I'm hurt. I love you so much and you are not responding, I am hurt. The Vaishnava tradition explains this phenomenon through five ways. First, how love, our regular love, ascends to Mahabhava, the great ecstasy. While you and God will, that is called divine communion, you will be united. There are different stages. In the first stage, they call it sneho. Sneho means affection. When my love begins, my intense love melts the heart and flows towards the beloved. That is the first stage. I really love you. So my heart melts for you and it flows towards you. That is the first stage of spiritual mood. In the second stage called mana, first is sneha, affection. Second is mana. Mana means peak. P-I-Q-U-E, develops when the lover's genuine love seems to be rejected or not reciprocated and the beloved feels guilty and tries to please the lover. It is a play between the lover and the beloved. The Vaishnava tradition depicts these things in connection with Krishna and the gopis. Oh, you do not love me anymore. You go. You go. I don't want to talk to you anymore. My love is rejected. You do not understand my genuine love. Do you know even what Radha said to Krishna? All right, I shall take revenge. In the next life, I will be born as Krishna. I shall make you Radha. Then you will understand how much love I have for you. That is called mana. The third stage is called pranaya, friendship. Creates the feeling of oneness. The lover feels the beloved's pain. What does it mean? When you have headache, I feel the same headache in me. When these two souls, two bodies, one soul. It is the soul, the mind, the feel for each other. My mind is united with your mind and I can feel your pain, pleasure, happiness, everything I can feel. That is called pranaya. Intense friendship, oneness with the beloved. The fourth stage is raga. Intense love is a tremendous passion for the beloved that brings forgetfulness of one's own body and transforms pain into joy. Example, Sanatana Goswami, a disciple of Chaitanya, was going to visit Lord Jagannath in Puri. He was walking over the beach. The sand was so hot by the scorching sun. His feet were burning, full of blisters, but he had no feeling of pain. That is called raga, complete forgetfulness of the vajajya for the beloved. I want to see my beloved. Fifth stage called Anuraga. A constant feeling of fresh love removes the monotonous state of the mind and generates unceasing waves of love for the beloved. Very interesting. Sometimes in human plane, our love generally becomes plateau, dull, which is not moving, just calm, and just stops. But anurag means they know how to create new waves of love, passion every day. The Vaishnava tradition created 64 kinds of mood. about love. You know, sometimes I say, you people say, I love you. But these people know how to make love interesting. I'm just gave you some ideas that how this Obhiman, we sometimes get hurt. Dude, I'm praying you so much, you're not responding. This is the way it works.